This week's edition of Church Media Design TV is sponsored by PrintManagementSolutions.biz. Welcome to another edition of Church Media Design TV, tips, tricks, and how-to for you, the church media designer. You may work in the church in kids or middle school ministry, or you might just be a graphic designer for your church, or you might be the lead pastor and you're wondering how to make sermon notes. And we're here to help you with all of that stuff. I'm your host, Brad Zimmerman, and I'm joined every week by my faithful friends, well, one was decapitated and replaced by another, but they're still faithful. It's the three wise men and Jesus. We have Colonel Sanders, Fred Flintstone, Little Whitey, and of course, Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord Most High. Well, in this week's edition of Church Media Design TV, we are going to be stepping into After Effects and making a magazine. Currently, at the church that I work at, we're doing a series called Tabloid Church, and so I was given the task of recreating a magazine, and so I'm going to show you guys how I did that and some tips that I learned along the way, and as well as we're going to give you guys some great resources and some freebies and some inspiration, and it's going to be great. So if the three wise men and Jesus are ready, let's get into it. Well, let's reach into the stockpile and grab you guys some great resources. And the first one is the new PSYOP How to Animate channel on Vimeo.com. Now, PSYOP is a studio that does amazing commercial graphic work. And the coolest thing is they just made this new channel on Vimeo on how to animate. And they kind of show the making of all of these different commercials, and they show side by side of what they started with and how they ended. And it's pretty unbelievable stuff. And it goes into, you know, how do you create, how do you get from point A to point B, how do you do storyboarding, all of that stuff. So it's something that I think you guys should check out. The next one is an interesting series of articles from Creative Church Media, which is Dave Smith. He's in Texas, and he works at a church there, and he kind of talked about how he's gone through some burnout in church, and he did a three-part series on burnout and what he went through and kind of some of the causes behind it. And so I want to encourage you guys, if you're feeling a little burnt out, you should check this out. If you're not feeling burnt out, you should check this out, because you will be burnt out one of these days. I get burnt out all the time, and it's usually my fault because I'm taking on more than I should. But this is a great series of articles that talks a lot about those things. So I encourage you guys to check that out as well. And then last but not least, let's give you some free stuff. And fudgegraphics.com actually is giving away free brushes from theshoreways.com. And this is some acrylic Photoshop brush textures. And I love me some good Photoshop brushes, especially like paintbrush looking ones. And so these are a really great set. They're all high res, 2500 pixels. And so they should work on most graphic work that you're going to be doing. So head over to fudgegraphics.com, creativechurchmedia.net, and PSYOP's How to Animate channel on Vimeo.com. Well, recently at my local church, we're doing a new series called Tabloid Church. And we were talking through 1 Corinthians, and there were all these different subjects that kind of were like gossip and all of these different like juicy subjects that, you know, people don't want to talk about a lot of times. And so we felt like it fell under the name of Tabloid Church. And so we were coming up with ideas on what to make. And I was basically said, hey, let's do like Harry Potter, and let's have like a magazine that kind of comes to life and has video clips that kind of go with the subject matter for each week, and we can reuse it, and it won't be too much work, and it will be a fun way to start it out. So I had to recreate a magazine. So my first task was, well, how should I do this? Should this be real, or should this be all After Effects? So I went and grabbed a Collide magazine, and I threw a couple dots on it and filmed myself throwing it down on a table, and went into After Effects and tried tracking those dots to see if I could do some tracking of the magazine to, you know, for my animation. And I realized this was not the best route to go. So I ended up making the animation that you're going to see next, which I did all inside After Effects. So check this out. So what you saw there was all in After Effects, and you can see that I, you know, threw a couple magazine covers down, and those were real magazine covers, and then it pans over to our tabloid church magazine. Now, this magazine was made of a bunch of different layers inside After Effects. I spaced them out to give it some depth, and then I did some page turning. And I'm going to give you guys a few hints on how I did that page turn. I'm not going to go into a ton of detail, but I'm just going to show you a few things on how I created it. So let's jump inside After Effects, and I have a composition set up here. It's widescreen. And what we're going to do first is we're going to pull in this wood texture. Now, I got this wood texture from... this is called seamlesstextures.net, and I went to their wooden textures, and I found this nice wooden texture that I liked. And so what we're going to do is just scale this guy down so it's about the size of the comp. And then I'm going to turn that into 3D. Then let's go grab a couple of my layers. And basically, what I would do for every week is I would save out. You know, here's my cover for week 3. This is Simon Gets Judged, the shocking interview with St. Peter about Cowl, Idol, and Heaven's Gate. Anyway, so that's my cheesy cover, and I had a lot of fun making these ridiculous covers. Bigfoot finds faith. What is he doing now, and why should you care? You know, just stupid crap. So anyway, so I would make my own covers and that kind of stuff. But what I did is I actually went to the store, and I bought a tabloid magazine. And then I took pages out, and I scanned those in. And I made a Photoshop document called Dummy Pages. And you'll see here, it's just a bunch of layers, and these are all dummy pages from a real tabloid. And the reason that I chose to not create every single page is, for one, I knew these wouldn't be on the screen very long. And for two, I wanted people, when they saw this thing flip through, for them to think, hey, that looks pretty real to me. Like, those look like pages I've seen in a tabloid before, because everyone's flipped through a tabloid, even though they may say they haven't. And so I chose to use these more realistic looking pages. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to scale these down. Then I'm actually going to separate these guys. Let's grab. And I am going to line these up as so. I'm going to hit, go down here into the corner, and I'm going to turn my rulers on. This composition is 640, and so I'm going to bring a ruler out to 320. You'll see my info palette pops up. I can close that now. And then I'm going to zoom in, and I can just move this guy over to the center mark here, and move this one over to the center mark as well. And there we go. So now these are lined up in the center. And now what I want to do is I actually want to make these both 3D layers. And I want to actually bring their transform point to the center so that when I do my rotation, it doesn't rotate around the center, but it rotates around the side of the page. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to use my pan behind tool. So it's right here. I'm going to grab this, and I'm actually going to switch over from my active camera to my front view. So front. And then I'm going to just grab this and click and drag. Whoops. Click. Oh, I got both of these selected. That's why it's going crazy on me. Let's grab this layer. I'm going to lock my background so I don't keep grabbing it when I don't want to. Okay, so we're going to grab this guy, and I'm going to start dragging. I'm going to hold shift. And it should lock right there to the center. And then I'm going to grab this one, start dragging, hold shift, and that one will lock to the center. So now, when I pull up my rotation property by hitting R for either of those layers, and I do a Y rotation, you will see that our page starts rotating. Now let's get a camera in here so we can see our scene a little better. So I'm gonna just right click and do new camera. 35 millimeters, fine, and I'm going to switch back from front to active camera. I'm going to hit the C key to bring up my camera transform properties. I'm just going to rotate down so I get a little bit more angle on my page. And then let's move up a little bit, and that looks pretty good. So now let's duplicate these two layers so that we have some magazine sitting there, and then I'm going to replace these. And this is really easy to replace layers. Save you some time. So we're gonna just go in here, and I'm gonna grab and alt drag this to my other layer, and then I'm gonna alt drag the next one to that, and now we have some new pages here. So now let's focus on animating one page flipping across, and then you can, at the end, go in and maybe duplicate this animation over and over again. So this should be fairly simple. And so my first thought was, well, let's use the Y rotation, and we'll flip it across, but you'll see we have a problem here. Once we hit the halfway point, we now no longer can see the, we're now seeing a reversed page. So what we're gonna need to do is we're gonna need to set up an animation. So I'm gonna do shift and page down, and I'm gonna go to 20 seconds. And I'm gonna set down a rotation keyframe for 90 degrees, and then I'm gonna go to my first frame and set one for 0. So now you'll see this rotates to 90. Then I'm gonna grab this page right here, and I think that's this page. And I'm actually gonna start that layer right here, and I'm gonna pull up my rotation, and we're gonna start the Y rotation at 90. I'm gonna end this layer here, and then I'm going to say 90, and I'm gonna do shift page down for 20 more frames, and we're gonna do 180. Oops, no, we're not gonna do 180. We're going to do 0. We wanna start it though, however, at negative 90. That's my problem. So negative 90. So now you can see our animation. We have a page that starts, flips over to the other side, and we have a seamless transition between the two. But one thing you can see is it looks very static. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add in a bending effect to kinda mess with people's minds and make them think that they're not seeing this really stagnant flat layer, but they're actually seeing something that's got some movement to it. So what we're gonna do is we're going to go to our effects controls. I'm gonna right click and go to distort. I'm gonna use CC Bender. And this is going to give me some bend points. I'm gonna go back to my first frame here, and I'm just gonna set a bend point on the outside here, and then set my base on the inside. And then what you can see is if I do my bending amount here, you can see how it kind of bends that page. And if I move my base point over more, when I do my bend, it's going to bend more at the center of the page. So now we can just simply lay down some keyframes. So I'm going to set a 0 amount here, and then I'm going to bend up. I'm gonna go to the center for right now, and let's see how far we can bend this before it starts to look fake. So we're starting to push our envelope around 90 pixels. And so I'll hit the U key to reveal all keyframes, and then you can see here we have a nice bend that has a little bit of, a little bit to it. But what I'm gonna actually do, so I'm going to set a easy E, or yes, this is going to be a ease in keyframe. And so it's gonna go faster of a bend at first. And then I'm gonna set a ease out for my actual rotation. So easy ease out. So what it will do is it's going to start bending the page pretty fast. And then maybe let's go, oops. Let's go maybe do page down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 frames in. We'll start actually rotating. So it's gonna bend up and then start rotating. Maybe we can even go back a little bit further. We just want it to wait just a little bit. And then you can see how we got some nice movement going on here. And let's, that looks pretty good. And then let's do our flip over on the other side. So we'll go here, we'll add our CC Bender. Let's set our 2 points. We're gonna set our top on the left on this one and our base on the right. And let's make sure our bend is working correctly. It is. So now we'll set our bend amount to 0 at the end, and let's go into the middle someplace here and see how much bending we can get away with. So we'll again bend this guy quite a bit. We'll go up to maybe 90. Again, hit U to reveal our keyframes. And you'll see that we have a nice bend on the other side. And you can really see how nice that looks there at the end. And one thing that I'm going to do again is I'm going to do a ease in here to ease that page down. And so it'll slowly sit down and kind of lay itself down. And then let's ease this guy in as well. So ease in our page turn so it starts real big and then it lands softly. So if we watch our animation, I'll just do our N key here, and then I'm going to hit 0, and it's going to render out our frames. It's going to take just a second because we're at full frame, and a lot of these things are pretty large images that we're using, but you'll see that we got a pretty nice flip to it. Now, I did that really quickly. I didn't spend a lot of time trying to get my bend as bent as I possibly could, but you can spend more time doing that. The one other thing that I did is I added in a light, and that actually helped give my scene a little bit more depth to it, and I would really encourage you to do that as well. So those are just some tips on how to set up a magazine. Again, to make your magazine look like it's more thick and more dense and not just look like this one piece of paper, space out your layers sideways. So if we quickly look here, so we're at the beginning. If I go to active camera and I go to, let's go to bottom view, and we grab our dummy page here, I can take and move this guy just down a slight bit. And if we go back to our active camera, you'll see that our layer, and actually let's move that forward as well. So let's take this guy and move it forward. And then let's move our wooden texture down a little bit. Okay, so we move that down, and now you can see that we have a little bit of, we got some doubling of our pages here. And once you do that like 7 or 8 times with all of your flipping, it'll look really, really nice. So that's a little bit about creating a magazine. If you have any questions about that, make sure to send me an email and have fun. Make yourself a magazine. Well, this week's inspiration comes from our how-to segment. This is a living magazine. There's a couple different shots here of how these people envisioned what a living magazine of the future would look like. It was very inspiring to my work for this Tabloid Church series, and I think you guys might find this pretty inspiring as well, so check it out. Well, this week's freebie is another game. Again, I'm doing middle school ministry and we're coming up with a lot of different games. This is actually an old game. I didn't create this, but I got graphics for you. It's called Fruit Basket Upset. This is the basic premise. You get a group of people, you sit them in chairs, and you number them off. And then, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. you know, and then you give ones of fruit, twos of fruit, threes of fruit, and fours of fruit. So, you know, somebody's apples, somebody's bananas, somebody's grapes or lemons or whatever. And then you start some pumping music, and then you yell off, you have one, pull out a chair, throw somebody in the middle, and then you yell off a fruit, and everybody who's that fruit gets up, switches chairs, person in the middle needs to find a seat. Now, you can yell off multiple fruits at once, as well as you can also yell fruit basket upset. And fruit basket upset, everyone gets up and switches chairs. And because I'm a sucker for competition, what I do is the person who is left in the middle is kicked out of the game, and then we pull a chair and a new person goes in the middle, and we keep going until there's only two people left. And then those are, you know, your winners battle it over the last chair. So that's a free background. You can get that in widescreen and in full screen from the website, along with a detailed description of how to play the game. And hopefully you guys will enjoy that. So check it out today. Well, I wanted to say thank you to our sponsor of Print Management Solutions, formerly DanzinkandToner.com. Now, Print Management Solutions is your one-stop shop to take care of all of your print needs. You're going to get ink and toner. You're going to get a service contract. You can even get a new printer, or you will get a new printer, as well as all of your care is taken care of, and you won't have to worry about your printer anymore, and you're going to save a lot of money. So I would encourage you guys to go check out printmanagementsolutions.biz. You can find out what they're going to, how they can help you out, and I would encourage you to click on the sign up button, send them your name, email, phone number, and put in the promo code ChurchMediaDesign, and Dan will get in touch with you and let you know how he's going to be able to help your church out today. So check out printmanagementsolutions.biz. Well, thanks for tuning in to another edition of Church Media Design TV. Hopefully you guys learned a little bit about how to recreate your own magazine, as well as a lot of other stuff. I really love being here and doing this with you guys. If you have any questions or you want to see something on the show, please let me know. That's the most important part. And you can email me, brad@churchmediadesign.tv, or hit me up, twitter.com/CMDTV, or you can leave me a message on Facebook. My username is facebook.com/bradley.zimmerman, because brad.zimmerman was stolen by someone evil, or maybe nice, I don't know. But you can leave me messages there, and I would love to help you guys out more with what's going on in your local church. And if somebody hasn't said it to you lately, I appreciate what you do in your church. You are very important and you are valued. And I want to make sure you guys know that, because what you do is very important. And the way that we use media to help tell the story of Christ is very much needed. And I want to make sure you guys don't feel underappreciated and make sure you guys don't get burnt out. And so just know that you guys are appreciated, and I appreciate what all of you guys do in your local churches. So as for me and the three wise men of Jesus, we're saying see you later.